Libraries Thursday Books and Babies. We're so happy you guys can join us. Today we are going to read books about monsters and about robots and about unicorns. So I think it'll be all fun stories. I think it'll be something for everyone today. Alright, we'll jump right into it. So we'll start with our hello song. Are you ready? Hello friends. Hello friends. Hello friends. It's time to say hello. Hello friends. Hello friends. Hello friends. It's time to say hello. Nice job. Should we wave hello too? All right, here we go. Everybody wave hello. Wave hello. Wave hello. Everybody wave hello. Let's have some fun. Stomp your feet. Everybody stomp your feet. Stomp your feet. Stomp your feet. Everybody stomp your feet. Let's have some fun. Everybody clap your hands. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands. Let's have some fun. Wave one more time. Ready? Everybody wave hello. Wave hello, wave hello, everybody wave hello. Now our song is done. Good job. All right, we are going to start with Are You My Monster? Think we can help him find his monster? This is my monster. He has sharp teeth, scratchy claws, a long tail, and he is green and brown. Are you my monster? Let's see. So you are green, but you do not have sharp teeth, or scratchy claws, or a long tail. You are not my monster. What about this monster? What do you think? Let's see. Are you my monster? You have scratchy claws and a long tail, but you have no teeth and you are red. Doesn't match this monster, does it? You are not my monster. Are you my monster? What do you think? Let's see, he has sharp teeth and scratchy claws, but you do not have a long tail. Look how short his tail is. And you are blue. You are not my monster. Are you my monster? You have sharp teeth and scratchy claws and a long tail. But you are yellow and orange. What color is our monster supposed to be? He's green and brown, isn't he? You are not my monster. Are you my monster? You have sharp teeth, but no claws, no tail, and you're purple. You are not my monster. What about this little guy? Do you think he's his monster? You have no teeth, no claws, no tail, and you're pink. Nothing matches. You are definitely not my monster. Are you my monster? You have a long tail, but you do not have sharp teeth. You do not have scratchy claws. And you're yellow. You are not my monster either. Will I ever find my monster? What do you think? Are you my monster? You have sharp teeth. You have scratchy claws. You have a long tail that goes swish, swish, swish. glad I found you. Now I can finally go to sleep. Good night. Well, it's great listening. All right, that one kind of helped us match colors and kind of compare and contrast, huh? All right, let's do a few more songs. What song should we sing today? Let's do one that we probably all know. Let's do Itsy Bitsy Spider. Ready? Not quite a monster, but sometimes they can be kind of scary, like monsters sometimes, right? Yeah, spiders can be a bit scary. You ready? The Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. The itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again. Good job. Let's do a couple more and we'll do our next story. Ready? Let's do one with our, kind of gets our hands moving, hands and bodies moving. Ready? Open them, shut them. Open them, shut them. Give a little clap. Open them, shut them. Open them, shut them. Lay them in your lap. Keep roll them, roll them, roll them just like this. Wave them, wave them, and blow a little kiss. Good job. All right, let's do our next story. So we had a book for all the monster lovers out there. And now we're gonna do a unicorn book. So this one is called Uni the Unicorn. In almost every way, Uni was like all of the other unicorns. She had a magnificent mane, though Uni's was extra magnificent. She had golden hooves, though hers were extra golden. And she had sparkling purple eyes, though Uni's were extra sparkling. Like the other unicorns, Uni had a special swirly horn with the power to heal and mend. And, like the other unicorns, Uni could make wishes come true. But there was one thing that definitely set Uni apart. Uni believed that little girls were real. Uni's friends laughed and said, "Ha, silly Uni. Everyone knows that there's no such thing as little girls. They're just make-believe." At home, Uni's parents just brushed it off with knowing smiles. But Uni was certain, absolutely certain, that little girls were real, no matter what everyone else said. Uni knew that somewhere far away, but not that far away, there was a little girl waiting, a strong, smart, wonderful, magical little girl. And she would be the best friend that a unicorn could ever ask for. Uni imagined all the things they would do together. They would run through the meadow. They would spin and twirl in the sunlight. They would explore and help forest creatures in need. Other times, they would just sit quietly and talk about important things. And, of course, they would slide down rainbows together. Uni fell asleep that night and had enchanted dreams. did not yet know, but would discover soon enough, was that somewhere far away, but not that far away, there was indeed a real little girl. And even though her friends said, "Ha, unicorns are just make-believe," and despite her parents' knowing smiles, this little girl was certain, absolutely certain, that there was a unicorn. A strong, smart, wonderful, magical unicorn. Just waiting to be her friend. And great listening. All right, should we get up and stretch and do a couple songs before our last story? All right. Maybe we'll keep clapping and stomping, ready to go. I can make my hands go clap, 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 clap. I can make my hands go clap, clap, clap. They're a part of me. I can make my arms go wave, 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 wave. I can make my arms go wave, wave, wave. They're a part of me. Can you stomp your feet? Ready? I can make my feet go stomp, 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 stomp. I can make my feet go stomp, stomp, stomp. They're a part of me. I can make my hands go clap, 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 clap. I can make my hands go clap, clap, clap. They're a part of me. What else can we do? I can make my lips go. I can make my lips go. They're a part of me. Good job, everyone. It's good stomping and clapping. All right. So well, can we do our thumbs? Ready? We'll do Tommy thumbs up. Tommy thumbs up and Tommy thumbs down. Tommy thumbs dancing all around the town. Dance them on your shoulders, dance them on your head, dance them on your knees, and tuck them into bed. Good job. All right, we found our thumbs. Can we do our fingers? Ready? Dance your fingers up, dance your fingers down. Dance your fingers to the side and dance them all around. Dance them on your shoulders. Dance them on your head. Dance them on your tummy. Tuck them into bed. Good job. All right. We will do our last story called Hello Robots. Hello Buzz and hello Beep. Hello, robots, fast asleep. Wake up! Get dressed, robots! Robots leaping from their beds. Robots standing on their heads. But you don't do that right when you get up, right? Time for shoes. Socks go on top. Then do a robot belly flop. Shorts and shirts, next underpants, then do a clanky robot dance. Does this seem in order? I don't know, we might have to find out. Brushing bolts before they eat, at the table, take a seat. Squirt the milk and pour the O's, robots know where each bowl goes. To the bathroom in the tub, robot scrubbing, rub-a-dub-dub. Time to progressed does not compute. Robots decide they must reboot. Let's see. It looks like they got their socks under their shoes this time. Good job, robots. Blast off! The end. That was great listening. All right. So that is it for today, but be sure to come and join in next week for more books and babies on Tuesdays and Thursdays. We'll do more board books and more songs, and we'll finish with our goodbye song. Really happy you guys could join us today. All right, ready? Goodbye.